Basically, what we do is we act as a support platform for launching rockets into low Earth orbit. We're currently involved with hypersonic development with several major companies. And ultimately, we will be looking to actually shoot these rockets that we would carry on our vehicle up into low Earth orbit. The aircraft is, as you can see the picture, is a very high speed, high altitude capable aircraft. And we're very excited about the future where we could go with this aircraft. We're hoping to be that innovative company that helps support the data centers in space, ultimately. We think we have something that's unique in the fact that we are currently operational, as opposed to several companies which are in the midst of development, but they're several years from actually being there. We're operational today. And we're at Kennedy Space Center, which is giving us a fantastic location to be able to operate these aircraft.
Yeah, now, Rick, I know that StarFighters recently listed publicly on the New York Stock Exchange. Why was this the right time to go public?
Well, we think we have something that's so capable right now that we think that the opportunity is there today. Sooner the better, as far as we're concerned. We've been in operation now for 30 years. StarFighters has been a mainstay within the aviation industry, starting as a demonstration team, and for the last nearly 20 years, we've been, as I stated, at Kennedy Space Center, and working on some of these new arenas that will actually help put these small satellites into orbit. And that's one of the things, too, that came our way that 10 years probably wasn't really even a mainstay within the industry. Nanosats are a much smaller satellite than what we were involved with when we first came to Kennedy. And that allows our smaller winged aircraft, as you showed the pictures earlier, to be able to carry a much larger array of these small sats and therefore be something that's capable and at a price point that makes sense with the rest of the industry.
Rick, who is your clientele? Is it government or commercial or a mix of both?
It's a mix of both. We are involved with both military, DOD, and of course, the commercial industry. We think we have a lot to add to the commercial industry, and that's one of our focuses, allowing for small businesses to be able to put these small arrays of satellites into this low Earth orbit arena. And not have to wait the long periods of time that it takes to do it on some of the bigger vehicles. And we're not in competition with the big companies, clearly, but we think we can help a lot of businesses be able to put these arrays in space, and again create these data centers for the companies that really need it, but don't have the availability or capability of getting them into low Earth orbit.
So when you talk about nanosats and some of your clients, you know. How much can you tell us about any specific mission? Can you give us some examples of what missions you've flown that maybe aren't classified?
Unfortunately, almost everything's classified with what we deal with, at this point at least. We're doing hypersonic development, and I can say that we've been very successful. The aircraft is a Mach 2 vehicle, and I can't tell you what companies we're doing what with, but the aircraft has surpassed almost every aircraft in the arena that we're involved with.
Yeah, well, Rick, you know, very interesting that the model is essentially, it's a service-driven model with repeat missions. So what do you think will determine how quickly you can scale revenue from here?
Well, I think it's going to be very quickly. Again, a lot of it has to do with the timing, and which is, we think, is now. We feel that we have a tremendous platform that we're using right now, and we are actually in the midst of even getting another platform that will work in a similar basis to what we have as an additive to our existing operations. We currently operate 8 F-104s out of Kennedy, and we are looking at expanding our operations in other spaceports as well. And I think that's one of the unique things that we can provide that a lot of companies can't with a ground launch vehicle. We can pretty much be anywhere, anytime. If they need us out west, we can be there, you know, short time period. Obviously, East Coast, we can do the same anywhere. And I think that makes us a very viable product.
Rick, can you give us a brief word, just because we're running out of time, can you give us a brief word on why it was important to be listed on the NYSE and to be a public company, ticker FJET, FJET?
Well, that's kind of funny, actually. F-jet, kind of fighter jet, that seemed to match it real well. And it wasn't actually my decision how it came up, but it was the right number, or the right designation, I should say.
No, I just mean what you'll do with the capital that comes in.
Oh, I'm sorry. Further development, additional aircraft to our fleet. And obviously, we're designing and developing our own rockets at this time.